Welcome, Disney fans, to episode two of Magical Main Street Dads. I'm Josh.
I'm Nevin.
And this time around, we're going to talk about ways that you can save money on your next trip to Disney. Because, we all want to go and we want to save as much money as possible to have as much fun as possible. So we have a couple tips for you here today, and we're going to go through them and, try to save you some bucks along the way.
And it's important that you save some bucks. This way you can spend more time with your family at the park. Because we all know that's the most important part.
Absolutely, absolutely. And of course, buying things for your family at the park. Like those fancy ears you got there.
Hey.
What's the story on those ears, man?
This is when Paint the Night was supposed to come to Disney World from Disneyland. Paint the Night is a nighttime parade. They do light up, and they actually the lights synchronize with the parade. Unfortunately, it never did come to the nighttime festivities at Walt Disney World.
Yeah, well, at least you got them. They're pretty cool,
Yeah, they are.
It's like the mistake thing. As a collector, that's something really cool to have, But yeah, so we're gonna go over a couple things that we think, people do talk about, but we're gonna give you some tips on the things that we found that have kind of helped us along the way, and some things that I just doing my research, I found out some things that I might have to change myself, So, the biggest thing is saving money for this awesome family trip, We're not going to talk about planning the trip necessarily this time around. We're going to get into that in further episodes, but it's how to save the money so you can start planning what you want to do, okay? And there are plenty of ways to save. One of the things that I do is I have a Disney Visa card, okay? I got this right before my last trip in 2017, okay? And they were running this promo that if you spent 500 bucks in the first 3 months, they would give you a $200 credit. So I was like, oh, well, it was $200 you could use for anything. So I put that towards my trip. Why not? And you get like the average 1% back. A lot of cards give 1%, 1 to 2, maybe 3% back. So I started using that Disney card for everything, gas, groceries, whatever bills I could do, And the key thing here, if you're going to use any credit card to get the points back or money back, is pay that card off right away. Okay? Don't use it and say, I'm going to pay it later. Pay it now. Just like you would use like a debit card and you're going to pump gas, you pump gas that day, go home that night, go online and pay that bill right away, just like you're using your debit card. And this way, you're not going to incur the interest, fees. Or if you have the money saved at the end of the month, pay it off at the end of the month. Don't carry that balance over. That's a key thing when you do with Disney or any other card, whichever card you're going to give you the best. But here's some things I found out about Disney is with there's two levels of cards, a regular Visa card, right? And a Premier Disney Visa card. And I knew about the Premier card, but I was looking at it this week and it's a $49 annual fee. But instead of 1% back, you get 2% back on everything. Okay. There's also other perks you're going to get with the Premier card. You're going to get 10% off shopping, dining at certain areas. You also get that credit, like I said, with the $500, you get a $200 credit. And as long as you buy something, you spend 500 bucks in the first 3 months. Who can't do that? You're going to do things like that. You get 2% back all the time on certain things at the park, outside the park, Disney store things. You get inside information on sales, things like that. You kind of get that with the non-Premier card. I've gotten things through the email, say, hey, use your Disney card, get X amount off at shopdisney.com, things like that. But all this helps. It's going to help you save some money. The other cool thing, and it works with either Visa card that you have, the Premier or non, are meet and greets just for these Visa card holders. When last time I went, we got to see, I think it was Kylo Ren, and it was just him. And it was a special line just for us, and we got in before everybody else. You know, it's almost like a fast pass, you know, hey, come on in. There's an Epcot meet and greet. I think it was like Mickey and Minnie. They probably rotated out a little bit. It's been a couple years since I've been there, but it was just for Visa card holders. So it was kind of tucked away over near Figment somewhere, and you went in and no line, basically. You went in, you got to spend the time with the characters, and it was cool. It's just something a little bit extra. So you get these other cool things in there as well. So that's something to think about. You also get 0% APR on your vacation package. So put it on the card. Yeah, you don't, I mean, you don't have to pay your vacation off right away anyway, but still, $200 down or whatever, you want to put some money down, put the whole thing on, don't want to worry about it, pay it off, whatever. It's 0%, you know, I think for the first 6 months or something like that.
Last I remember, it was 6 months.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's pretty much, I think, with both cards, but still something to think about. There are so many perks, you know. And if you don't know if you should go with that Premier card, because I was like, I always put it off. I'm like, $50 a year. Am I really going to, you know, spend that much? But then I've been looking at my bills, and I'm like, spending a little bit more than I should have, you know. And I'm like, that definitely would have helped me out. Like, if you spend, say, $1,000, you know, it's definitely worth it. Mm-hmm. The cool thing is there's a calculator on their Disney Visa card website, and you can put in what your groceries are for the month, what your gas is, what your, you know, do it by the month, do it by each individual trip. I would have ended up with hundreds of dollars more, and I'm like, oh, I'm kind of stupid enough for doing that. So I'm seriously going to look at this myself. And, you know, I do it. I'll let you guys know how I make out down the road. But I think it's a really interesting, and I think it's something that you should check out. It's really going to help you out.
Yeah. No, that's great. And I'm glad you brought up the meet and greets. The last time we were there, one of the hardest meet and greets, a lot of people don't know this, is the Seven Dwarfs. They had, in the middle of the day, at Fantasyland, at Magic Kingdom, Seven Dwarfs just for the Visa card holders.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, you can only get them at Halloween time if you're lucky. But yeah, they do stuff like that. But I know a lot of people are like, you know, let's be honest, my credit may not be great for that. There is another option. A lot of people don't know, you can pay for your Disney vacation with Disney gift cards. So if you get what's called the Target Red Card, I believe Costco has this as well. But I just know personally from dealing with Target. The Target Red Card is like a Visa debit card. It's hooked to your own checking account. So you're not even spending money you don't have. You're not accruing interest. But here's where the kicker is. You get 5% back on every purchase. So if you buy a $100 gift card, you're getting a $5 discount. So you're really spending $95. Now, much like your little 1%, 2%, you're like, oh, that's not a lot. You times it by 1,000, that's $50. I know people who have paid over $6,000 on Disney gift cards. That's almost $300 off their vacation right there.
Absolutely. And you know what? $300 goes, you know, well, it might not go a long way for certain things, but it can go a long way when you're at the parks. You know, depending on what you're buying, you know, what you're collecting, whatever. Every little bit helps. That's the thing. You said it 1% here, you know, 2% here. You're talking about 5% off. It helps. Yes. Every little bit does help.
Absolutely. And like I said, it's linked to your own checking account. So you're not spending money technically you don't have. So you don't have to worry about that. Oh, I got to pay this off now, or wait, now I'm only going to pay a little bit off. You don't got to worry about it. It's money already you have. It's coming out of your checking account. It's done. And like I said, I will be honest, it's kind of daunting scratching off the back of the gift cards and entering them one by one on there. But hey, saving money is saving money. You do what you got to do.
Absolutely. And you know, you have it linked to your checking account, correct?
Yes, that's correct.
So that's like, how do you save money in your checking account then? You know, hey, it's Disney. Make a sacrifice. You know, like, don't go out for that latte every day. Okay. You don't need to buy lunch every day. Nope. You know, this is a trip for you, your family, your kids. Maybe you don't have kids. It's just for you and a loved one. It give something up. You want to go there and, you know, save even, you want to do the old fashioned savings, you know, put $50 away a week.
Yeah.
You know, add that up until you get somewhere in your checking account that you can do the Target Red Card thing, you know, pay off your credit cards, et cetera.
Some of the things I do, obviously, like Josh said, stop getting lunch every day. You know, I take leftovers and things like that for lunch. You know, it is what it is. If I got to eat the ramen noodle thing, it's what it is. It's Disney, because you may sacrifice for a year, 2 years, but when you're with your family, those memories are a lifetime.
Absolutely. You know?
And everybody will remember that. And trust me, the food is a million times better anyway. So.
Yeah, you ain't getting ramen at Disney, you know, so.
Yeah. You're not getting ramen.
You know, except for the salt intake on ramen, you know, I think I could do that for a year if I could save some money to go to Disney. Sure. I just couldn't eat chicken all the time. I'd have to change it up a little. Chicken, beef, throw some shrimp flavor in there, you know. So, you know, we just talked about how to use some of the credit cards and, you know, the gift cards, and you have all this money now. What else? What are you going to use it for? You know, you're going to book your trip, right? So hopefully that's what you're saving for, right? You know, and there's a couple ways to book your trips. And I've done it a couple different ways. My first trip, I went with my brother and his family, my sister-in-law and niece, and my son. And my brother and his family had a timeshare. So we stayed there and we just got tickets, you know, to go to the parks. So it was, we didn't have to save so much, you know, but the next time I went, you know, I stayed on property and I flew in and I had the Magical Express and everything like that. I had no clue how to do this. You know, did a lot of research online and everything. And I booked it myself, calling Disney, you know, sitting there for hours on the telephone, you know, just listening to the music, you know, sure, it's cool and everything, you know, but you just want to book your trip. But it can take a couple times, twice. It took me 2 hours, 3 hours, you know, by the time you get through. You go and you book everything where you want to stay, you know, talk about some meals, you know, where you're going to eat, you know, meal plans, et cetera. It's a pretty decently long process. I've done that twice. Now, the last time when I was supposed to go this year, and obviously didn't go in June, I booked through a fraternity brother of mine, his travel agency that he belongs to. And I think maybe I'll put that link down below for you. It's really easy to do. And the thing when you go with like somebody like this, he's an authorized Disney, you know, agent. So Disney's paying the commission. Okay. There it's free, and that's what you want to look for. And that also saves you money. You know, don't go to the travel agencies where you're going to get charged or anything. Go to the free fee places like this, and they will do the work for you. So you're not on the phone for 2 hours. I just said, hey, man, this is when I want to go. You know, these are the dates. This is dates I'm going to be at the park, etc. He said, okay, I'll take care of it. The next day, I get an email. Here's everything linked to my Disney account already. gave them all that information, you know, gave all the information on who was going. Everything was in there. I looked at my account the next day and I'm like, perfect. Can you do it online and go through all that? Yeah. You know, but sometimes it's so much easier to have someone else do it. And it got to the point where I'm like, you know what? I've done it on my own for a couple times. I want someone else to do it. And it is a great help. Okay. And the thing is, remember, go for the fee-free agents. Okay. And this is Vacations Through Chip, and really good guy. He also works at Disney. So he has tips that he can give you, you know, which is really cool. That's the other thing about these places. And you hear about perks too. When people say, oh, I booked through this agency and I got this for free and I got that for free and this. And I'm like, how'd you get all that stuff for free? Disney is not giving you this for free. Okay. No, but these agents might have things that they'll, you know, send out to the hotel for you. A welcome package, things like that. There are agencies that do that. To me, that's not super important as much as like, just take care of it for me, you know. I don't want to deal with it. They're too old for that. But those are kind of the cool perks you're gonna get, and they're experienced. A lot of these agents live down in Florida. They've been to the park so many times. They go there on a weekly basis. So I was like, hey, what can you recommend a place to go eat? Oh, five places, bang, like that. Places I never even thought of. I'm like, oh, nah, I'm not going to like that. Then I really look into it. I'm like, I'm going to go there. You know, like, I just never thought of going to these places. Those are the tips they're going to give you. If you go at it alone, yeah, you're still doing it on your own, but it's a little bit more stressful. So it's not really saving money per se, but saving you the stress and the anxiety of trying to plan everything on your own. Now, these agencies will do your fast passes if you want them to. They'll do your advanced dining reservations if you want them to. Personally, I like to do that stuff myself because I'm a little OCD on my fast passes and what time I want to eat. But if you give them a time and say, I want to eat at, you know, Crystal Palace between 5 and 6, they're going to get you in, you know? So, you know, it's more helpful time-wise that you can now focus to save money in other ways. Okay. But overall, are you going to save time? Yes. And that's very important because you're going to be stressed out enough planning this thing.
See, where Josh doesn't like doing that, I do like doing that. I like to sit down and plan and sit down and look and analyze what I want to do. I'm going to show you now. The biggest expense is definitely the hotel. Which resort you're staying at. Let me tell you something. I've stayed at Values. I've stayed at Deluxes. You're going to get magic no matter where you're at. All right. I hate the terminology value resort. It makes it seem less important as a deluxe resort. I've had no bad experience at a value resort. None. The cast members are great. The resort is spotless. It's clean. You know, let's face it, not all of us, because some of these deluxe resorts, $700-$800 a night. I mean, the Polynesian bungalows are $12,000 a night. They're always empty for a reason. All right. So
that's where I'm staying next time.
Yeah. Even this tip won't really help you with that one. But one of the things Disney has is called a vacation club. And Josh said he went on a timeshare. It's the same thing. It's Disney's version of a timeshare. And all they do is deluxe resorts. All right. So you got resorts like Contemporary, Grand Floridian, Polynesian, right there at Magic Kingdom on the monorail loop. Those resorts are very hard to get, very expensive. Like I said, Polynesian, $800 a night, easy. I'm in the middle of planning a vacation for me and my wife. We're going to be going down, celebrating our 25th anniversary, 1,210 days away, but nice. I'm not counting.
No.
I'm going through a company called David's Vacation Club. Now, David's is authorized by Disney. What that is some vacation club members can't always go and use their points. Well, they still have to pay Disney. It's like a mortgage. So what they do is they rent their points through David's. Now, I looked. I'm staying at Polynesian. That's my favorite resort. I grew up with Polynesian. It's expensive, but hey, it's my anniversary. I'm going all out. Through Disney Direct, the time of year I'm going, it was $757 a night. Through David's, $450 a night.
Wow.
Right there is almost a $300 a night savings.
That's a lot.
That's huge.
Yeah.
The resorts are the most expensive piece. It's where you want to stay. It's huge. And again, I hate the term value resort. I hate it because the value resorts, I've stayed at All Star Sports. It's gotten a bad rep as being like an Econo Lodge type resort. It was furthest from that. All right. Furthest from it. So I hate that term value resort. If that's where you and your family want to spend, because let's face it, sometimes like when we went, my daughter and I went, we went with my grandkids, we went for 10 days. We were looking for a place just to crash, shower, hit the parks. With my wife and I going, we're going to want some time, you know, to chill, you know, hit Trader Sam's, got to get to the Grog Grotto. So I can stagger home right there, so I don't got to go nowhere. But I prefer to stay on property. Josh alluded to the Magical Express. A lot of people don't understand. Disney is almost 45 minutes away from Orlando International Airport. You can Uber, you can Lyft, you can do all that. You can rent a car. Disney will do it for free.
Absolutely.
You get the Magical Express. It's a free ride to it. Although we changed the words coming back, it's the Tragical Express on the way back.
Everybody has like that sad look. Like,
yeah, it's either that.
Everybody's just talking. Everybody's like on the verge of crying.
But Disney will even pick up your luggage for you. You don't even have to get your luggage when you get off the plane. You just go to Terminal 1, get on the bus, hit the resort. Your luggage shows up at your hotel room.
I love that. I love that.
Awesome. That, and when you leave, you can check your bags in at the resort before you get on the bus.
Yep. Done that.
Yep. All this saves time and money. I mean, yeah, some people like to rent cars. By all means, if that's what you want, go ahead. I'm trying to save money, especially with Galaxy's Edge. I need me some lightsabers.
Absolutely.
But David's Vacation Club, it will link to your My Disney Experience app. Their customer service is great, very helpful. And you can go to any of the deluxe resorts. You have Old Key West, which is the original DVC resort. There's the new one. Oh, my God. Now I'm forgetting the name of the new resort. The Monte Carlo one. I forgot the name of it now. Oh, my God. I'll look that up and get it to you guys. I'm sorry. Oh, it's the newest one. The Skyliner's with it, too. I feel so bad now. But there's Contemporary, Bay Lake Tower, Polynesian, Grand Floridian. All these are the deluxe resorts. And you can go through David's and get them at a fraction of the price.
So that you told me about this, and I'm like, it confused me for the longest time until you really broke it down this week as we were like prepping for this episode. And I'm like, it clicked. And I was like, oh, that's pretty awesome. You know, and if you're going for that deluxe resort for that, you know, commemorative vacation like you are, it makes total sense. And no, we'll get into the difference between the resorts at another episode for sure. And we're going to go in depth on that. Yeah. You know, but the thing, like you said, you know, the resort is the most expensive thing. And you want to save the money, you're obviously going to go for the value resorts. That's where I stay. That's where I'm going to stay for a while, you know. you know, because I spend my money on other things, you know. I'm a big Star Wars fan, and I collect everything Star Wars. That's where most of my money goes at Disney, and the other classic Disney things. So I'd rather spend my money on that. And that's part of your budgeting too, is when you're thinking about anything from your airfare to the resort you're staying at to the dining plan, if you choose that, whatever you choose, budget how much money you're going to have to spend in the park for that extra fun stuff. The pins, if you're a pin collector or trader, the ears, people collect ears, I mean, whatever it is, you're going to want the souvenirs to come home
Yes.
with, and there's so many like exclusive and souvenirs that are only there for a limited time, Exactly. So you want to pick those up, next time you go back, they're not going to be there. Certain things will be there, other things definitely will not, and a lot of it isn't. That's how you also have to budget, I don't have to. I'm not telling you I have to, but my tip is think about how else you want to spend your money besides the airfare, tickets, resort, food. Think about the other things. Do you want another experience when you go to Disney Springs? You want to ride the hot air balloon thing? Do you want to do a virtual reality experience?
Your
Do
voice.
you want to hit the Lego store? All sorts of things. Have a night on the town with the Mr. or Mrs. All these things you got to think about.
And the thing I always go for is, again, the most impactful is family time.
Yes.
Do not say, I can't do this because it costs, I want to do this, but it costs too much. There are so many different options and ways to save money. You may not stay at the deluxe. Like Josh said, we're going to go into the hotels. You can try a moderate. Go to the value. I always say go to the value, Save $300 a night on your hotel room so you can do what Josh was saying, all the extras.
Right. And if you're going for, some people might only go for 3, 4 days. They hit a park each day. They're for 4 full days, whatever. I go for 9 to 10 days. You just said you went for 10 days. Like, I'd like doing 2 days at each park, or maybe take a day at Disney Springs, the relaxing day. We'll get into that as well. But these are all things you have to think about. And the longer you stay, the more you want to save. Okay, so think about it that way as well.
Well, I don't know about you, but I think I got some things I gotta think about.
Yeah, I do too. I'm really thinking about the Premier Disney card, upgrading that. I'm like, huh, because I ran through the calculator and I'm like, I could double my money. Hey, if we all have expenses, and as long as you're, like I said, you're going to pay it off, do it. Think about it at least. Think about it. So I think we gave you all a lot to think about. If you have any questions about what we talked about in this episode, previous episode, or have a question that you want us to get into on another episode, drop a comment below. Okay, let us know. If you don't want to do it there, you can send us an email at magicalmsdads@gmail.com, and one of us will answer you. Okay. We're also on Twitter at Magic Main Street Dads, and that's Magic Main ST Dads. Okay. We're going to be on Instagram this week, and I'll get that out. I'll tweet that out, and we'll put it up on the Facebook page. Find us on Facebook, Magical Main Street Dads. Just search us. We're going to pop up. And, we're putting great information, polls, questions, trying to have some fun with everybody. Let us know. Get involved. We want to be, talking to you. We want you to talk to us. We want you to be part of our family. We want to be part of yours.
Well said.
So I think that's it for this round. We're going to get into, like we've said a couple times, everything else that goes into planning these trips. So now you have a little bit of a base of how to save the money. What do you do with that saved money, right? All right. So we'll see you Disney fans later.